bit of breaking news, by the way, and it ties in with our next subject. The Bake Off Christmas, not the Bake Off, the MasterChef Christmas special has been pulled by the BBC. We're just hearing that. But he's going to be kept on air, Gregg Wallace, and the other programmes for the other bits and pieces. Let's remind ourselves of what Mr. Wallace said by way of an apology yesterday.
I want to apologise for any offence that I caused with my post yesterday and any upset I may have caused to a lot of people. I wasn't in a good headspace when I posted it. I've been under a huge amount of stress, a lot of emotion. I felt very alone, under siege yesterday when I posted it. It's obvious to me I need to take some time out now while this investigation is underway. I hope you understand, and I do hope that you will accept this apology.
So there it is. MasterChef stays on air, but not the Christmas special, Charlie. How are you going to get through the festive season without it?
Oh, I think I'll survive. I think I'll just about get through it without Gregg Wallace. But you know what? This is, in a funny way, I mean, I was prepared to come on and sort of, you know, lambast the decision already to say, look, you know, he shouldn't be on screens because the justification of the BBC, well, there are two ways of looking at it. Even by Gregg's own admission, if he's now saying, I need some time out, I need to, you know, even though there are people that he's clearly offended and there's a reason why he's been taken off television, there is still a duty of care, you always hear that, to everybody who's on television, regardless. So, you know, the idea that Gregg Wallace, if he's said he needs to take time out, will be appearing over the festive season, I think would just be wrong for him, certainly wrong for the people that he's obviously offended and upset and whatever other allegations there are that are pending. So it shouldn't have been on. Anyway, but in a funny way, if there was ever going to be an episode that should have been shown, because the BBC was trying to justify that it's not just about one individual, it's about all the other contestants as well, you would have thought, actually, if there was one episode that they would air, it would be the Christmas special and not the other ones in between.
Yeah, you might think, just stick it on at Christmas and then have done with, and then, you know, we can all take a rethink after that.
Yes, yeah. I mean, I agree with the decision that he shouldn't be on at all, but it seems a bit sort of bizarre that they're sort of just pulling that one, it seems, if that's
right. It's a difficult one, isn't it? If somebody makes an allegation, then straight away the argument is you take that person off until you've established. Now, that does seem, you know, a little unfair in some respects because, you know, you're almost being found guilty before you've been found guilty or not guilty. Just by dint of the, because of the high profile nature of that business, they pull all your programs and that's it. Straight away, people go, well, he must have done something wrong.
Yeah, I think it's the it's always the follow-ups, I think, as well, where, you know, one person, obviously, if they felt offended by something or if they feel as though something totally inappropriate has taken place and they speak up, that's one thing. Mm. And obviously, the BBC or any other broadcaster would have to go and investigate that. But if that becomes public and all of a sudden you then have a sort of snowballing effect of other people coming out, then actually it becomes an issue where I don't think you're left with much of a choice other than to say, all right, we've got a series of allegations of inappropriate conduct or misconduct, so we've got no choice but to pull that individual off or to one side whilst they investigate.
Let's move to this story. Junk food ads will be banned before 9 p.m. Yes, this is and online in a bid to tackle obesity. Unfortunately, it means, Charlie, we'll get no more stunning commercials like this one.
Hey, look at there. Didn't I tell you it was finger licking good?
Kentucky Fried Chicken. If you want Kentucky Fried Chicken, you have to visit me.
That is the Colonel. That's an ad from 1969, Charlie, and we've been munching on his chook ever since, to coin a phrase. Listen, I don't know how where you are on the junk food stakes, Charlie. I'm sure you a late night Mackie D or a kebab every now and again. Would that be reasonable?
Well, I think one of your producers must have been peeping through my net curtains because I had one of those last night. Very late.
You had a what last night?
I had a KFC last night.
Did you? Well, what about that?
The Colonel paid me a visit.
The Colonel came round personally. The spirit, at least, of Colonel Sanders. you see, I think you can't beat KFC pound for pound when it comes to takeaway food.
Well, funnily enough, I've never had. This might be a revelation to you and your listeners and viewers, but I've never had a KFC until I moved to where I currently am now in Putney. And I don't know if I can have.
You'd never had it until when? Sorry.
Until earlier this year.
That was your first soiree into the KFC world.
It was, and I'm hooked. I am hooked.
You're a chicken addict. I love it. So, how had you swerved the Colonel's Chicken Parlour all of these years, Charlie Rowley?
Well,
you I went think to that's... university. You worked in Westminster. You'd had late nights. You'd worked with Michael Gove. If anyone likes a bargain bucket, it's Michael. So, how did you avoid it?
Well, you're right. At uni, I was certainly surrounded by other late-night food outlets. A particular Ronald McDonald was there.
Would that have been your go-to? Would it have been a Ronald?
Oh, yes.
Yeah. And have you now crossed the Rubicon to the Colonel?
I've grown up, yes.
Yeah. It is. It's a rite of passage, I'd like to think. Three pieces, right? Large fries, barbecue beans. I mean, that's all you need in life. I mean, not much more than that.
It is. But now, you know, the high streets, you know, there are options as well. If I fancy Five Guys every now and again, which, you know, I know that's a bit more fancier.
I'm not going to judge you on your personal life. Let's stick with food.
It wasn't just the Colonel that came round.
Listen, I'm glad you've sampled the delights of Colonel Sanders. Charlie, thank you as ever. We didn't even get to talking about the ban itself. Adam, our producer, has just said in my ear that KFC in Australia is superior. Now, I'm an Australiaphile, Australian, whatever the phrase is. I had KFC in Australia a lot of times. I thought it was a bit dry. I'm just saying, you see, one of the reasons I like the finger-licking good thing down there at the parlour is because it's a little bit greasy. And when you order one and it's dry, I think I've got a moody KFC on my hands. You've got to have that juicy kind of grease coming out. Simon goes, I don't like all of that. That's part of it. And that beautiful secret recipe that covers the poulet in a beautiful way. Everything about it is stunning, although I don't know why they changed the recipe of their chips quite recently. That was a bit of a mystery, but there you go. Banning ads, I'll just say it because we ran out of time with Charlie there. I don't think banning ads will do a single thing for childhood obesity. I think it's as simple as that. My kids are 10 and 6. They are painfully aware of all that goes on in the takeaway world because they see it around them all the time. You can't miss it. The golden arches are there for all to see. The Colonel's Chicken Parlour lights up like it's literally heaven, not the nightclub. I'm talking about, you know, the place where you go afterwards. An ad online is not going to make a blind bit of difference, I sense. We'll take your thoughts on that as